In this video,
I'll be diving a little deeper into head comfort zones. So let's go ahead and get started. As I've mentioned in my Medium blog article, Physical Factors for Head Comfort Zones in XR, when designing UI elements and interfaces within a virtual environment, real-world physical ergonomics should be taken into consideration. Be sure to keep head rotations within comfortable ranges, especially when using gaze targeting or for longer durations or more repetitive tasks. Assuming a person is sitting or standing still and focusing on something, the most important elements should stay within a 20 degrees head tilt up and a 12 degrees head tilt down vertical space. The main elements that you're wanting to be within the user's field of view with a comfortable head turn should be within a 154 degree horizontal space. An easy way to measure this is to hold your arms out straight and place your hands where they're still visible within your periphery. The maximum required head turn should be kept at or below 204 degrees horizontal, or where your arms are stretched out as far behind you as they can be to the sides, assuming you have normal range of physical motion. I'll walk you through some practical examples of this with Rec Room VR. Since people come in all shapes and sizes, it can be hard to set up a standard positional setting of UI panels for everyone. Even relational positioning can be a little tricky with the current technology. Rec Room's menu panels are summoned from a watch on your wrist. When summoned, you hold up your wrist to keep the panel active, and when you lower your wrist, it goes away. This is a convenient option that allows you to summon the menu without having to remember a physical controller button. And it's immediately relational to your actual height. The problem comes in when you hold up the watch for any amount of time. Your arm's inevitably going to start getting tired. And that in turn makes your arms lower, which then adds strain to your neck. Or in the case of Rec Room, the menu goes away when you're in the middle of doing something. Rec Room is aware of this issue and has tackled the problem by giving you the option to either hold the panel up with your wrist or to pop it out into a panel that follows you around spatially in the world. This would be an ideal solution if you have the time and the budget to implement, since it gives the power to the individual to set it up how they need it. They also include skeuomorphic handlebars on the panel to let you know that you can grab it and position it however you want. And that then solves the problem of head comfort zone and lets the individual tailor it to their specific height and comfort needs. I highly encourage you to check it out for yourselves in VR on Steam, Oculus, and PSVR. It's also available in 2D mode on PC with Steam, PlayStation, Xbox, and iOS. However, for the sake of learning best practices for XR, I recommend VR mode. I've included the link below in the show notes. So for a quick recap, be sure to keep physical ergonomics in mind. Try to keep the head in a natural position as much as possible. Ensure head rotations are within comfortable ranges. Where possible, allow the people to adjust the panel position as needed. And give options for popping out the panel in-world versus holding it where feasible. And finally, avoid designing environments that require extended or repetitive look-up or look-down interactions.